When I ask people about trust, they start talking about distrust, about feeling abandoned or betrayed. Philosopher Annette Bayer wrote, "Trust is like clean air. You only notice it when it's vanishing, when it's disappearing. And we really need trust to function." I studied trust in organizations. Why this subject? Well, I moved from Holland to Italy 22 years ago, and I noticed that I felt uncomfortable in my new working environment. I didn't fit in, not flexible enough. By leaving Holland, I realized what being Dutch means. And this feeling gave me an example for today, the King's speech during his inauguration. You saw him already, and I hope.
In het midden van wederkerig vertrouwen ligt een voortdurende opgave. In het klein en in het groot. Dat zei mijn moeder in haar laatste kersttoespraak als koningin. 33 jaar lang heeft zij vertrouwen gegeven en het haar gegeven vertrouwen niet beschaamd. En dat is de basis van haar gezag. Zij stond voor de waarden die in de grondwet zijn verankerd en waaraan zij zich op 30 april 1980 plechtig had verbonden.
The king, he represents the values laid out in the constitution. In organizations nowadays, leaders formulate core values. I worked this winter for Shell, and I reminded the leaders their general business principles: honesty, integrity, and respect for people. In society, the constitution, and in organizations, core values. That's a starting point for trust. So therefore, my first statement for leaders in organizations, so please put into practice your core values. Deeds, no words. Woorden maar daden. As the supporters of Feyenoord, the soccer club of Rotterdam, sing. But the king, he went on.
Ik treed aan in een periode dat velen in het koninkrijk zich kwetsbaar en onzeker voelen. Kwetsbaar in hun werk of in hun gezondheid. Onzeker over hun inkomen of over hun leefomgeving.
He talks about uncertainty and vulnerability. And he makes the connection with the need for mutual trust and collaboration. Trust and uncertainty and vulnerability are related. When you trust me that I will finish this talk in about 8 minutes, you accept the unpredictable aspects of my behavior. You take a risk, and by doing so, you make yourself vulnerable, even if you don't feel it that way. That's the clean air. But currently, many of us have this feeling that the acceptance of vulnerability has been abused. Our perceived certainties on employment, on pensions, on healthcare, and they have disappeared. And with that, the trust in those leaders who exercise power, like bankers, politicians, CEOs, they failed to live up to their core values. And what else went wrong? Let's look a bit closer into this concept of trust. Trust is a positive feeling. Oh, sorry. Here you have trust which has gone away. The air got polluted. Anger and fear came up. And that's not what we want. So therefore, I spoke about these leaders who failed to live up to their core values. But something else went wrong. Let's have a look closer into the concept of trust. Trust is a positive feeling, an aspect of relations within a certain context. And fear and anger are negative feelings. And those negative feelings are a signal for betrayed trust. So we have to investigate them by investigating our relations and our context. I told you I moved to Italy, where I was not happy in my working environment. Then I had the opportunity in 2000 to work for a Dutch company again. The context changed and my working environment became predictable again. My relations and my performance improved and I regained my self-confidence. That's my personal experience. But in organizations, it works the same way. We all need predictability and goodwill to accept our vulnerability. That doesn't look too difficult, does it? So, what else goes wrong? What is missing? This is what I found. In uncertain times, leaders look for solid ground. They concentrate on hard data. They concentrate on key performance indicators, on measurable objectives. That is what they have learned to do. But that measuring is not enough. We need to understand what is going on. And we have to ask the right questions, investigating into our relations and into our context. And that's the difficult part, because this sincere attention goes into deeper layers, layers where our feelings of safety and justice rule, as well as shame and guilt, feelings that make us vulnerable. And that's exactly what leaders prefer to avoid. It feels disconcerting to admit mistakes, to expose emotions, or to show uncertainties. That feels like losing control. Primatologist Frans de Waal, he demonstrates us that the chimpanzee alpha male can't afford to show its vulnerability. It would be the end of his leadership. And many human beings, particularly our leaders, they behave still the same way in their struggle to get on the top position of the rock. Frans de Waal, he makes a plea to work on our empathic and cooperative part, which also exists in our nature. He switched his research to these subjects. And so did I. And I've learned that embracing vulnerability is essential for creating trust in organizations. So leaders, be courageous. Embrace vulnerability. As Brené Brown stated in another TED Talk, vulnerability is the birthplace of change, innovation, and creativity. So please, leaders, close the circle in complex situations. Then, showing vulnerability, you make a powerful act instead of something soft. After this vulnerability showing and goodwill, you create predictability and clarity, and then fear and anger will disappear and mutual trust will reappear. Our king, he made a good start. He is, as a role model, a real trust worker. So it's hard to work on trust. But please, leaders, now you know what you have to do. And we, citizens and professionals, let us be courageous too. And choose those leaders who have these skills and qualities, because a democratic people gets the leaders it deserves. Thank you.